So good afternoon, everybody, and good to see some known faces here. And well, as this is the age of gig and the way the gig is going forward, I thought of choosing this topic for today's. And another thing is, I'm sure since morning there are many sessions wherein we talked about white collar since morning. So when I was deliberating on what to speak, I thought of choosing a topic which will be much more relevant and will be slightly different. And that's where I choose this, that blue is the new white in thriving gig economy. Now, the coverage that, a bit about me, because I would like to share last 2.5 decades that I am in L&D, I would like to share some of my experiences while working with blue collar. And then of course, why I call blue is the new white. See, till now we have heard that whenever the gig name comes, it was most of doctors, lawyers, chartered accountants, then off late software developer, and so and so on. There are a lot of freelancers who have joined in this field force. And in fact, by some research, they say by 2027, US 50% workforce will be gig. 50% of US field force will be gig, cutting across industries. Now, in India is also, I'll share with you some numbers, we are not far behind. So the thing is that thanks to the new age companies like my own Zomato, and then of course Swiggy, so those are the food delivery app aggregators. Apart from that, there are other companies like rideshare aggregators, Ola, Uber. Thanks to them, today we have a very sizable number. In fact, you would be surprised that 10% of the total gig force is from the blue. And that's what makes me to say that blue is the new white. Of course, being in L&D, I am sure this question must have baffled you a lot. Isn't it? Whenever we have gone to our bosses, or maybe for that matter to operations or business, and ask about any intervention, the first thing which is asked to us is, what is the ROI? You won't believe, I still remember way back in 1998 when I proposed the first intervention in Torrent. I was literally assigned Dr. Srinivas Rao, who was our mentor. He was a professor from IIM Ahmedabad, and he literally 6 months really grilled me to see whether I am the right selection for Torrent or not. Because they said, why so much investment is required in L&D suddenly? So the point I am saying, each one of you must have faced, and I would share some insights, some case studies that I have come across in last 1.5 decades, working with blue collar employees especially, and creating case studies wherein we have proved that we can reach to Kirkpatrick level 4. It's possible in each of the industry. One is missing, the Reliance Retail, because incidentally I do not have any data and therefore I am not putting. Rest of the thing, I will prove that we have some data to share, and these are not the stories. So of course, this is what, because we have only 20 minutes and I think 5 minutes have already been taken in the last session. So I would like to keep it as brief as I can. However, if you have any question or maybe any discussion, we can have it later on. And I'll be here around, and I would love to answer your questions. So moving on. Well, it's been a long journey now, it's 4 decades, out of which first 1.5 decade was purely in sales and marketing in one single company, Lupin. But then onward, it's a journey, and I have worked by now in 6 different industries, right? Starting from pharma to telecom to retail to e-tail to BFSI, and now in food tech. So, and all these companies where I work, we have created L&D, and believe me, Kirkpatrick level 4 case studies that I would love to share with you. Of course, these are the few books that I have authored so far. I am still writing. So my 6th, 7th, and 8th books are in the pipeline. And recently I started, because nowadays I am told that people are not interested in reading books. So I have stopped writing. In fact, that is the reason my other books are in pipeline. And I started a YouTube channel called vivekmehrotra.com, wherein I keep putting my own videos, whatever learning that I had in those 4 decades, I like to share this with the rest of you. So I would love if you can visit and see and then give me a feedback to improve further. So that's it. Now let's move on to the topic, gig. I'm sure you all know gig. We have lots of freelancers, but as I said, that thanks to rideshare, that is Ola, Uber, and then Zomato, Swiggy, and there are many more to come. In fact, the entire e-commerce wagon is ready to join. I just read that till now, Amazon, they were having their own fleet, but they are launching what is called as Amazon Flexi. With that, they are now coming in the field of gig as well. So even e-commerce, if it goes, and then more and more will continue to join. So gig is going to be the future, it is already. Just you will be surprised that India contributes 40% of the freelance job globally even today. Thanks to our software industry development, the way it has gone up, I think we are one of the major industry here. There are 15 million skilled professionals working as on today. By this number will go up to 2025, this will become 25 million. And there is a slight mistake, I'm sorry, as a trainer I should not have done that, but galti mistake se ho jati hai. So this is, read that average numbers are from 10 to 40 is the range, 10 to 45 is the range, average gig income is 19 lakhs. And by the way, these blue collar, to whom we call as a blue collar gig economy, like the drivers who come and deliver food at your doorstep, any guess what could be their salary, how much they are earning? 10,000? Any more bid? 40? Any more bid? 50,000? Good. So I am saying, this year you are very, very modest, conservative in giving your numbers. I have today more than 500 people who regularly every month earn 80,000. My son is sitting here, he works for my competition Swiggy. And incidentally, he will swear by that he also has, Swiggy also has same amount of numbers, 500 plus, who earn 80,000 plus. Then there are roughly 10,000 plus who are earning 40,000 and beyond. The point is, they are earning much more, but still we call them as a blue collar. But Indian freelance market size is going to be 30 billion by 2025. Now, let's talk, come back, as I said that today we will talk only about the blue collar. There are 2.1 million jobs are available today in the year 1920, out of which 1.4 are in gig. And this 1.4 in gig are only for the two verticals, that is your delivery 8 lakhs and your drivers which are 6 lakh. Rest are not included. Imagine the numbers that will be and how much opportunities it will provide to us. And it's of course everywhere it is available today. However, these are the major south 5 states which contributes to the maximum. And there are 3 cities, major cities, Delhi, Bombay, and of course Bangalore. Bangalore being the number one, which contributes to these number. You want to take a picture? I'll give you the presentation. No cost. By the way, my all books, I have given one single acknowledgement that I was not Abhimanyu, you knew everything before coming on this earth. Therefore, if you feel that this was your sentence, I have copied, it is my acknowledgement to you. All books, common this thing, because the thing is what? I have read everything, I have might have seen somebody on the video, I'll share the presentation entirely. They can share my presentation. No property right. Now coming to the point, this is in India. Among this blue collar, there is a high attrition rate. And in fact, in Flipkart, I myself have faced 200 plus. So 300 is don't. blink your eyes or widen so much that you feel that 300 is too much, but then it's a fact. And how many of you agree to this? How many? Many. I'm sorry, I would beg to differ, and I have data to prove. Believe me, I agree with you. What you are saying is that this looks like that, and in fact in Flipkart we have challenged this, that this is not a situation. This is what we have started. This is a coaching intervention that we have done as a mission transformation. It is, these are the numbers. The overall attrition has come down from 18% to 8%. Early attrition, that is 30 days, has come down from 8% to 4%, and absenteeism has come down from 6% to 3%. So it is possible through, in fact we had what we call it as customer experience coach. So we have launched 137 customer experiences coach across India, and who has resulted into this kind of numbers. So it is possible. It looks like on the face of that the people, they want to leave just because of money, but then there are other factors as well, and if we can take care of those factors, I have the entire case study. I would love to share with others if you can get any benefit out of that. I am sorry, you might be feeling that I am trying to blow my trumpet, but that's what I am doing, and I am purposely doing it. The reason is, in L&D all of us do an excellent job, but what we fail to do is we fail to do our own marketing. Is it true or not? So then please do that, because if we want, now HR business partnering we have listened for years, but this is the time when we should talk about L&D business partnering. And this will only happen when we become, from a support function, if we can become the support center. But that will only happen, like I was listening to the previous, and I'm sure there were certain questions around these things, that how to ensure. So this will only happen when we take certain concrete measures which can help us. Because if L&D has to become a credible and a critical part of the company, then what we must ensure is that our training, whatever we do, whether it is ILT or digital, it should impact performance. If it doesn't impact the business performance, and this performance must go to the results. Right? So what Peter Drucker said, that he was asked once that what is management, and he has very beautifully explained that management is an organ which converts mob into organization and efforts into performance. How beautifully. And that is what exactly we mean, that if we can convert the efforts which people are putting into performance and can produce tangible business results. And with blue collar, it is much more possible. Because blue collar, they are always on the ground zero. In fact, I always reminded of one of the saying of my president, Mr. Sapre, while we were working in Lupin. He used to say that we have only one revenue earner, and that is our medical representative. Right from Lalan, Lalan was his driver, to DB Gupta, who was the chairman of the company, he says we all are the cost. Do you agree to that or not? He is the only revenue earner. But somehow, when it comes to L&D, we miss this particular portion. If we can take care of blue collar, so-called blue collar, I am saying if we can take care of our front-end people, because they are impacting business result. Business results are in their hand. We talk big, big things in terms of strategy and so many things. But please remember that strategy has to be implemented in terms of getting business result. Am I true or not? And if that has to true, it is that person in the bottom, he has to first appreciate that this is the right thing to be done, and then he should do it. If he doesn't, nothing happens. And that's where this, if we can take care in our organizations, question is how. So as I was saying, I will share with you in brief my 3-4 organization wherein we have worked. This is a way back in 2005, when Reliance Infocom used to exist. Today it is not. But point is, in 2005 we had this Webword, which was their cocoa stores, in which this was almost a flat. But in 3 months coaching intervention, it has gone up like this. Same way in franchisee, which we call used to call it as a WWE, Webword Express, there again it was almost flat. The CSAT score has gone up like this. Even the trouble tickets, those of you who have worked in call centers and all, I'm sure you know, trouble tickets, they were all everywhere in every cluster, they have reduced. Why? Because of one coaching intervention. So again and again I am saying, training, coaching, we have to decide in L&D what is the appropriate intervention for a particular role. Even in Flipkart, as I said, in Flipkart we discussed about coaching. The another one is, of course, I would not discuss much because this is still Clerk-Patrick level 2. I would take you to the Clerk-Patrick level 4. Here, if you notice, you will appreciate that from January to December, the number of orders delivered have gone up from 75,000 to 1 crore every month. But if you see rest of the customer escalations, they were almost stagnant or the same, or maybe slightly increased. Because for a NPS, like a company like e-commerce company, what is the best thing? It is the customer NPS. And we were given charge of this, that at least there should not be any customer escalation. Coming to a different industry in Janalakshmi, which is a microfinance organization, we had suffered a very bad patch in 2017 after demonetization. And that's where when we decided is that we have two sets of area head, the bottom and then there were top. So we have taken this 168 bottom area heads and we developed a coaching intervention on 8 different business parameters. And you can see in each of these business parameter, we have shown that there is an improvement. Whereas the people who were not coached, performance of either slided down. So this is possible. Again, as I said, though they were not, area heads were not the blue collar, they were in the, I would say, gray collar. They were the supervisor category. But then there also we could prove. Moving on to this, for the first time in my career of 2.5 decades in L&D, I came across an audience which does not belong to me. For the first time, the gig came into this, when is because I was used to of these people who will come in my classroom and my trainers will go and deliver, but there was hardly any time. So what we did is, in fact, we have completely digitized training. Today we do not need any trainer, no projector, no classroom, nothing. Everything is through app, the same app that they use for their delivery order at your place, they use the same, we use the same for the training. And the results are like, this is a coaching intervention. Again, like, very important is that we must have their data first. Now you imagine 3.5 lakh people, 40,000 new people joining every month, and you are paying salary without a PAN card. What kind of liability it will have for the company? And we have taken care, the numbers have come down, the errors have come down from 19% to 2%. Again, this app that I was talking about, through that we have ensured that even the repeat offenders, because most important is that all L&D interventions that we do are good. But what happens after training, and here you have seen that only the 10% have become the repeat offenders. And last and not the least, this is again, is a business requirement that there is no attrition in gig. People, they log in, no, or they go log off, up to them. So in this, what we delivered, like we were asked is that, how can we ensure that the people who are there on the board, they log in, and you have seen that we have made it within 3 days. And this is a pure training intervention, wherein what we did, we created Google Forms. After the training, the Google Forms are given to them and we are asking them to put their first order experience. So in a way, we are pushing them that they deliver in 3 days and they are giving us the feedback. And that's how what we have ensured, the numbers are in front of you. From 31%, we have gone to 44%, 50 orders, and the first order has gone up from 67 to 83. So with this, I would end because she has already come up here. So I should not make her stand. The bottom line in L&D is one, that L&D is a service that business consumes with ease and creates impact. If we can do it, I'm sure we all will continue to do a good job. We are already doing a good job, but we will continue to do a good job. Thank you very much. These are my coordinates. We can catch anywhere and everywhere. Thank you very much.